Hello, my name is Terry Kenny, and I'm a service water specialist with the Water Science Field Team. And today we're going to talk about using offsets in GRSAT. So you can see I have GRSAT open on my screen here, and I am now going to load the example XML file or primer that deals with offsets. So I will go File Open, click on From File. I'm going to navigate to that XML file, which is shown right here, Offset Primer. I'm going to select it. I'm going to click Open, and then I'm going to click Read Data. So you can see we have the measurements for this particular site, the Sandy River near Mercer, Maine. They plot nicely on a curve. Typically aren't going to see this in the natural world too often. But we see this curvature in the measurements, and therefore we know that we can likely use an offset to straighten out this relationship. So the first step you're going to take whenever you're going to be changing offsets is you're going to start with a new rating. If you're changing the offset, it's the moment to change to a new rating number. And so right now, if you look in the rating manager window over here, we're dealing with rating number 0000. And I'm going to clone that rating by clicking on this button here that looks like a sheep for cloning ratings. And I'm going to give this a new rating number. I'm going to call this 1.0. And I'm going to leave a brief comment. New offset developed. Ideally, you'd leave more detailed remarks, but for this example, this will work. I'm going to click OK. And now you can see we are dealing with this cloned rating. It's shown up here, rating number 1.0. You can look in the rating period manager, and it also has a new rating that is highlighted. You will also notice that the original rating that we dealt with is still shown up here in the tab. And I can navigate back and forth to and from that in and of itself. So something you'll learn right away is GRSAT has options in which the scales will automatically reset themselves when you do different activities in GRSAT. And you will quickly learn that certain actions that you take will be beneficial to have it auto-scale, and certain actions that you take will not be a benefit to have it auto-scale. When dealing with offsets and trying to find the proper offset for such a curve that we're seeing here, it's typically a good idea to have the automatic scaling of the axes on. So I can go up here into Setup, and I'm going to say Automatic Rating Scale On, and you'll see that there's a check mark next to it when I click on it. And this will ensure that when I change the offset, the y-axis will automatically rescale itself so that you can see things changing. So we're dealing with offsets, so we want to go into what we know is the Offset Manager. Click on the tab here on the right, and we are at the point right now in which these measurements are being plotted at a zero offset. We can see right here, zero offset over here. What we want to do is resolve a new offset for this relation. And to do that, we're going to select offset 1. And so now you'll see we have the ability to use these radio buttons to toggle it up or down. But we also want to make sure that whatever we toggle here is reflected in the screens or the windows shown on the left. And so in order to do that, we need to make sure that we are plotting an offset 1. So we can see that we have a relation between stage and discharge in this case that is concaved when plotted at a zero offset. So that tells me that I need to increase the offset in order to get this relation to plot on a straight line. However, before I go through the exercise of changing the offset, I want to make sure that I'm only dealing with measurements that are specific to the hydraulic control that I want to straighten out the relation for. From my notes and the experience that I have with this station, I realize that there are two controls represented here in this rating, and I am interested in straightening out the control or the measurements associated with the control for stream flow below about 10,000 cubic feet per second. And this is an exercise you're going to go through whenever you have a station that you're building a new rating for, and it's the the exercise of going through and censoring out the measurements you are not interested in including for the resolution of the offset or for drawing the rating curve to it itself. And such censoring or filtering could be filtering out specific control conditions in which the control wasn't clear, you have backwater, you have debris on the control, that sort of thing. You wouldn't want to include those into your rating curve development because they bias the way that line is being drawn. Typically, you want to make sure that you are developing your rating for clear control conditions. Now for this one, I want to filter out measurements that are above 10,000 cubic feet per second. So I can go into the site visit data pane here that I made a little bit larger, and I can click on any of these column headings to sort the column itself. And you see there, I clicked it and now I'm sorted from highest discharge down to lowest discharge. And so I want to get rid of everything above 10,000 cubic feet per second. So I can select this column or row right here. I can push the shift button or push it down and select the next one that I want, and all the other ones in between are going to be highlighted. I could just drag my cursor down through the measurements I want to get rid of. They're all highlighted here, and I want to click the X to unselect them. Now I'm going to go view. And I'm going to send this back into the default rating shift layout, and you'll see those ones that I unselected are now gray. And you can leave them gray because you're not going to see them or not use them because they're not colored. Or you can also decide to turn those off here, and you can show and hide unselected measurements here, and you'll notice the gray goes away. Pretty handy. Now, like I said before, you want to make sure that you are not biasing your rating development to conditions on the control that are not related to clear conditions. And so once again, I could take this site visit pane out, make it a little bit larger. I can sort by control conditions by clicking conditions. Right now, all the clear ones, this is alphabetical, are showing up first. I'm going to click it again, see if there's any others that I'd like to get rid of. And what I see here for this specific station is I just have some older unspecified control conditions and clear conditions. I don't have any here that indicate there's debris on the control or that it's scoured out or anything such as that that I wouldn't want to include in this rating development. So at this point, I am happy with what I have filtered out, the measurements above 10,000 cubic feet per second, and I am ready to try to resolve a new offset that straightens out this relation. Once again, I'm going to go view. I'm going to go back to the default rating shift layout. And now I am going to go back to the offset manager here. And I am going to start changing that offset to try to get this relationship or this relation to straighten itself out. So the method I follow when I'm trying to resolve a new offset for a curved segment or a curved relation between stage and discharge is I like to input 2 points, one near the bottom of my curve and one somewhere near the top. And you'll see here that 2 points define a straight line, and there's a straight line that goes between these 2 points. And that illustrates some curvature that's shown or seen in the relation in and of itself. You'll also notice that after I put those two rating points in, the variable shift diagram becomes activated down here on the lower right, and there's some obvious curvature going on here. When you consider that the zero line is represented by the rating curve that I've just input here. And so when using GRSAT, this is one of the greatest advantages is the ability to just use the trial and error process of changing the offset to get to a straight line relation between stage and discharge. So I am going to toggle up this offset and see if I can get the measurements to plot somewhere on a fairly straight line. And so you'll see I went beyond the likely offset for this segment, and the rating curve kind of curved downwards, and now it's not concave anymore, it's convex. And so at that point I know I kind of went past the inflection point, and I'm going to back up this offset to where it starts to look like those measurements are plotting on a fairly straight line. What I learned from doing this little trial and error is that there's a good chance that my points that I initially selected here maybe need to be adjusted. So I can go to the Move Rating Point tool right here, and I believe that this point needs to come up just a slight bit, give or take. and you'll notice that things start to change in the variable shift diagram. They also changed in the radian plots, just not quite as obvious. And I think I need to move this point just a little bit as well to where I'm capturing a little bit more of the measurements. And what you start to see is this relationship in the variable shift diagram that initially had this little curve to it is starting to straighten itself out a little bit. And I can toggle this offset up a little bit more to see if I can get those to kind of curve in. And you can kind of see where that inflection point happens. It happens somewhere around 1.7, 1.8. Again, this is an iterative process in which you're going to move rating points to come up with a place where you're going to have this straight relation, and then afterwards you're going to add or extend your rating curve outwards one direction or the other to capture all the measurements. So I move this lower rating point up just a little bit, and I'm starting to see things straightening out a little better over here. I bumped it up to 1.9. That looks decent. Just to be sure, I'm going to highlight this section over here to kind of see what's going on. It does suggest that there's some extra curvature kind of going on at this lower end. I'm going to move this up just for fun and see if I can get things to kind of straighten out above that point fairly well. And it seems like I'm doing okay here. The fact that I can't get this entire segment that I've decided to work with on a single straight line suggests to me that there's the potential for some sort of a lower water control, hydraulic control affecting this lower end below about 100 cubic feet per second. It could be some sort of a section control that's up closer towards the gauge that gets drowned out as flow gets above, say, 3 feet or so of stage, to which then you're in a section control that's defined here by this segment that I've kind of outlined by my two rating points here. So what you can see is, like I said, it's an iterative process. You have the ability to easily roll or move or change the offset up or down by using these little radio buttons and see how the relation changes in respect to the straight line you've defined with your two rating points. So the next step you would take here is you would work on extending the upper and lower portions of this rating to capture the hydraulic control segment you're interested in, and potentially adding multiple offsets due to the other segments that are likely to exist. The one we just indicated or talked about below here is likely a different hydraulic control, as is the stage and discharge values above 10,000 cubic feet per second would be another or third hydraulic control that you would have to resolve an offset for. Please check out the multiple offset video that goes over how to deal with multiple hydraulic controls and multiple offsets to resolve a rating that is comprised of straight line segments connected by smooth transitional curves. Thank you.